watch Nigerian TV news briefs, here are the highlights of the news making the rounds. I am Blessing. Latest report from Ernst & Young shows that Nigeria's ease of doing business index is low and thus rubs up negatively on her foreign direct investment. The country currently ranks 131 out of 184 countries. The Nigerian Association of Chambers of Commerce, Industry, Mines and Agriculture, NASIMA, has called on government at all levels to step up efforts at enhancing the growth and development of the private sector. The World Bank has approved a yearly fund of $2 billion to enhance job creation, social service delivery, and governance in the country. The fund, under the country partnership strategy, will be made available to Nigeria through the International Development Association and International Bank for Reconstruction and Development Financing. The Nigerian Communications Commission has said that the instability in power supply is hindering the manufacturing of mobile phones in the country. NCC Director of Public Affairs, Mr. Tony Ojogbo, stated that before a mobile phone manufacturer could invest in the country successfully, there must be a stable power supply, among other factors. Azura Power Holding Limited has signed a $750 million contract involving $220 million of equity and $530 million from a consortium of local and international financiers on debt financing of its 450 megawatt Azura Edo Independent Power Project. And on the foreign scene, United Arab Emirates owned carrier Etihad Airways and Philippine Airlines have signed a memorandum of understanding to mark a new era of cooperation and partnership between the two carriers. Mobile technology company Nokia today.